happy to be here with one of Minnesota's own, one of the newest members of the Minnesota Wild, JT Brown. It's great to have you here, and there's so many players like yourself that grew up playing hockey in Minnesota, and now it seems to be on every roster a couple of players sprinkled, and we saw it in the Stanley Cup. What's it like for you guys when you're in those cities and there's other Minnesota players? What type of connection do you have with those guys?
That's always nice. You feel like you already know them just from being a part of the state, but to get to see them out there and see their success, it brings joy.
Vikings are a really big deal in this town, and your dad was a really good running back in the 80s. I grew up watching Ted. It was a little bit before your time, but as a young child, how much did you hear about your dad as a Minnesota Viking?
From him or from...
For everybody in town, because he was a really well-known guy.
No, it was fun. I think even just some of the best memories were going to some of the Vikings training camps and kind of getting the side pass and get to go in different areas where you weren't allowed to go because he had played for him before. So, you know, you definitely get to see it and then see some of the old the clips as well. It was good growing up.
You've always been a guy that was built on speed and a tremendously fast hockey player at a young age. But with that background, and your dad was a star football player, and football is also all about speed, how did you end up focusing so much on hockey?
He let me choose. I mean, that's kind of the way that it went. I played both sports growing up, and by the time I came to high school, he kind of realized that hockey was the one that I wanted to play, and he's basically said the same thing to me since I was a kid, and he has always just told me to play hard, play smart, and play together. I mean, those are his words, and that's kind of what I've lived by, you know, and how I model my game.
Get to play a couple years in the USHL, and you come all the way back to Minnesota to play college hockey for UMD. Tremendous run there, and it's really exciting that you're going to be playing home games at the Exxon Energy Center, because the memories you have as a player in that Final Four, you were the most outstanding player, your team won a national championship. What made that team for UMD so special? We saw it on the ice, but more importantly, off the ice.
I think we're all friends. I mean, a lot of us knew each other before we even went to Minnesota Duluth. You know, obviously, Rosemount connection with my best friend, Luke, and, you know, to be able to play with your actual friends and to have that sort of connection before you actually step on the ice and play just made things a lot easier.
Here's a chance, and Brown scores!
What has made the NHL such a special experience for you? Everybody talks about trying to get there. It's a faraway place. Every kid kind of says, I want to score a goal. I want to get my first point. I want to go to a cup. You've done some of these things. What have you been able to learn about how tough this league is?
That's very tough. It's a grind. I mean, I've been to game 6 of a Stanley Cup final, and, you know, I've missed the playoffs. So I've kind of went through it all. And so you just got to know that it's not going to happen every year. You can't win the cup every year. You don't see it. And you just got to keep pushing. I mean, that's what it is. It's a grind, and you got to make sure you're ready for it.
Tell me about Fortnite. I'm the father of 3 daughters. They rave about this game. I've never played it. I'm not a guy that gets into all the video games, but it's such a craze right now. And you've done some great work with this game. And we'll get into the charity side of it. But the game itself, what drew you to Fortnite?
For me, it was just it changes every single time you play. It's never the same. You can land in the same location, but that doesn't mean the loot's going to be the same or the circle's going to be the same.
It's like hockey.
Exactly. So no matter what, you can have a strategy, but it's always changing. It's always thinking on the fly of what you're going to do.
Now, on that side of the conversation, you've done a marathon version of Fortnite where your charity of choice is Hockey is for Everyone, something we celebrate here in St. Paul every single year. What drew you to that charity?
For me, it was just, I've known about them obviously playing, and we have Hockey is for Everyone month, and their core values is just aligned right with myself. So to be able to obviously, one, raise money for charity, but I wanted to keep it within hockey, and that right there was a no-brainer for me.